purely for work purposes, for a Studio 10 exclusive investigation, I have uncovered some extraordinary evidence about Mr. Doran. I'm bringing you this exclusive report from the makeup room here at 10, the place where he has spent most of his time while he's been here at the network, where he's undergone extraordinary transformations to be prepared to be ready for on air. Let's take a look at some of this explosive evidence now. We've seen his makeup bag. We have a curly twist with enriching serum. We also have a lovely little toupee, I would say. We've also got the beauty blender, a number of hair care products, because we always know that he loves to get a check shot or two. This is the mirror, quite subtle, like Matt, that he often uses to get the check shots before air. Also, bombshell. Look at this extensive array of different foundations depending on his colour that week due to fake tanning purely for work purposes. And also lovely sweet rose organic Indian tea. Seriously, Matt, I am devastated you're leaving 10. I will miss your professionalism. You're a fantastic journalist, a wonderful writer, but most of all, I will miss your friendship and also your wonderful sense of humour. I wish you all the best.
I was about to say, isn't she horrible, but then she goes and redeems herself.
The audience is just all absolutely taking that verbatim as though I do have organic Indian tea.
But
toupees.
You do, though.
I can promise you it's not true. I'm denying it categorically.
Yeah, we are very sorry to see you go, but the good news is the makeup department is actually pleased to have the extra cupboard space.
The extra resources, yeah.
For you, Joe. Well, Matt, you are leaving us here at Channel 10. It's definitely our loss. Big loss, you leaving. Yeah. And who better to send you off than your partner in crime, Natasha Belling? Get out of here, Pat. I wasn't going to miss an opportunity to completely stitch you up, Mr. Doran.
Oh, what a sad day for the nation.
Thank you for those lovely words, too.
Oh,
back
it was
there
all
as well.
Sincere.
That was great.
You know, there's some cakes. I know you're going to love that.
Have a seat.
And let's just have
a look. Are they
all
for me or not?
Your face is on cupcake.
Yeah, which is disturbing on so many levels, isn't it?
I don't know if you can see that. Careful.
And the colours of the...
It's not the first time your face landed, is it?
Was that deliberate, Joe, or was that
just a bit of
taken as a sign on the way out?
Just a bit of professional jealousy.
Can I
put the cupcakes down?
And then the colours of the flag, the American flag.
Now I know you guys have been talking about what a loss Mr. Doran is. That's going to be leaving 10. You have done extraordinary work here during 10. This is me being sincere.
I can never tell whether you're being sincere or serious.
No, you've done excellent reporting. You're a beautiful writer. You're a great journalist. You've done such fantastic work right around the country. Let's take a quick look at your work here at 10.
This is 10 Eyewitness News with Matt Doran.
Good evening. It's proof you can't win in politics.
We better warn you that the behaviour in the following story is both dangerous and illegal. Police will also use information obtained from this nearby office works to allege that this crime was at least several weeks in the planning. Thanks for joining us on Wanted, where police are again appealing for your help. Inside almost every one of these bars, there's an offer of underage sex. The spread of poverty in villages and provinces across the country makes this fertile ground for traffickers.
How much do I get for just a glass pipe?
Are you aware of the fact that what you've tried to sell me there is illegal in New South Wales?
Roger Balacoco is an organ broker, and in just 2 years, he traded more than 300 kidneys.
We needed money to repair our house because we are a broken family.
And can now exclusively report that what began as a missing persons case has now become a double murder investigation.
Are we winning this battle, Arthur? Can we win this battle?
Now, international media crews are fleeing here rapidly. We just don't know how to get out ourselves. We are trapped here presently without any fuel. These people may look calm and orderly, incredibly they are, but let me tell you, they are starving.
We have not eaten.
For how long?
3 days.
Matt, what can you tell us?
There are a number of people here who have spilled out of all of the buildings adjacent to the Lind Cafe where this is all unfolding. It's always a good time. Now, Putin
Britain's plan here, of course, is to transform not just a region, but an entire nation. And watching this host nation walk out, well, it's difficult not to be very, very impressed.
We're missing a point. They are fantastic.
So you change your mind now?
It must be pretty tough being famed for your backside, though, Limo, right?
Oh, yeah, it's been a lot of pressure on me, Matt.
Kit Flan, what say you?
Oh, Matt Doar, I'll tell you what. Tip number one.
See why you got offered this great gig, really. Yeah, it's fantastic work.
And I love it how you've got stubbly Matt and clean shaven Matt. It's kind of like good Matt and evil Matt.
Do you know
Matt?
How much angst that caused in the newsroom as well? My news director actually sent me a razor down to work one day and said, take the hint. Wasn't happy about it. We're probably good reason.
But let's forget about complimenting you. Let's talk about your wonderful sense of humour and let's have a look at funny Matt. Take a look.
How do you put a price on memories, Tash? Can you put a price on memories?
Matt, what can you tell us?
Alia Zilic was on the...
Alia
Zilic was in the custody of South Australian major crime detectives when he arrived here at the airport a short time ago. Zilic was shackled and seemed heavily sedated when he... Zilic was shackled and seemed heavily sedated as he was led from the plane to a waiting unmarked car.
Oh, no.
Thank you, Matt. Matt Doran reporting. Police reporter Matt Doran joins us. Matt, what happened? Well, what can I say, Matt? You left a trail of broken hearts after your short stint in Adelaide, and your move to the US even cracked the advertiser. So you're still big in Radelaide. From all of us here in the Adelaide News team, we wish you all the best. We know you're going to be a huge success.
This is quite extraordinary. We do have some breaking news for you today. Dr. Patrick Reed from Offspring is dead. So I can't cook and I can't change a tyre. What have I got going for me?
Jeez. Good looking boy, mate. Thanks,
mate. Nat Cath wraps up all of the front finance for Wednesday. Are you
kidding? Come on, let's see it.
Now to Doran the dropkick.
In breaking news, Matt Doran's been slightly inconvenienced.
Oh, look at you, Matty Doran, with your Mediterranean chisel good looks, complaining about waking up in the morning.
Times are tough.
You didn't get your normal quantity of Tinder in. I know it's been difficult.
It's been a rough morning all around.
You were the only man I know who could go to a crime scene and come away with both an exclusive and a woman's phone number. That's truly different. All the best in my life.
What's even more exciting is you're going to donate your time and hand deliver the cheesecake in an apron and nothing else. I think Matt Doran is joining us now. Are you there, Princess?
You need some new material, I think, Natasha.
This is extraordinary behaviour. Oh,
take us through these early snaps. Was that your ice baby phase?
Oh, wow.
Look, oh, God. Can you believe it?
This is...
Can I just interject before the people of Australia become nauseous over dinner? Revenge will be sweet, I have got to tell you, Natasha.
Matt Doran, our loss is everyone else's gain. Just keep those baby blues sparkling. Just do it right now. Just do it wherever you are, whoever you're with. Just give him one of those big...
Dirty old Matt Doran, America's most wanted. You're Australia's most wanted, my friend. And you need to be staying here.
Just don't forget the little people. Steve Price.
One of the great men, one of the true professionals, one of the best smiles in the business. And when I think about all the people I've worked with, there is absolutely no doubt that Matt Doran is at the top of the list.
Hey, Matt, Peter Halley here, mate. Just want to say, first of all, congratulations on your amazing new gig. We're going to miss you. It's always fun hanging out, and hopefully I can get over to the US and we can hang out again. You'll probably be so busy doing your fancy crime show that I'm probably going to have to shoplift or stab somebody just to hang out. So hey, good luck, and we'll catch up soon, buddy. Well done.
Well, I never thought this day would come, having to say goodbye to Dora, our beloved Matt Doran, an excellent journo, my partner in crime, moving on to brighter and better pastures. Certainly much bigger, Matt, but the days of wanted loom large for me. I wish you all the very best. You know you'll be dearly missed around here, and hopefully one day you'll come back and say good day to the little people.
Oh.
Maddie, we love you, and fingers crossed for a tremendous career ahead.
Oh. Oh. We've got you a little survival pack.
Look,
to head over to the States, pack? Where we know you get man flu, so there's some...
Thank you.
Yeah.
There is a little bicky for you, for your one fan that you'll get in the States.
That's just the one pack I see you've arranged. Thank
Here
you.
Is your organic sweet rose tea that you drink often.
Can't go anywhere without that. Very important.
And some of the best, there's still a stitch up to come. You know your nickname's Disco Doran because you love hitting the dance floor.
Oh.
So this is a little disco ball.
Surely the stitch up has come already and been and gone.
I am loving this.
Some of those photos you've shown there should never be seen publicly. There should have been a viewer warning, a discretion.
I think they were from the brief window where Billy Ray Cyrus was working in the hair department.
Hang on. You know, they also dug up my first ever live cross there, which I thought had gone to God. Like, that was just the most terrifying. No. That was another time. that was my first ever live cross, I froze. And the guy's name was Ali Azilich, I remember now, the accused. And that's just brought back all sorts of trauma.
But it was so good to see, because that last bit where you just like, oh, I've said it.
I just slumped, Jess, for a long, long time.
OK, we will put a warning on this following vision. Take a look at Disco
Doran. What I love most about you is that you're an alleged journalist, but also you're very humble in regards to... You have this extraordinary ability that you really haven't shared with Australia. Let's take a look.
Here we go.
Good afternoon, Natasha Belling in the 10 Newsroom. There is plenty making news this afternoon. London's Olympic Games opening ceremony goes off with a bang, watched by a billion.
Some pretty windy conditions across coastal parts of Victoria and West.
Really drop down those temperatures as well. As we move through the rest of the weekend.
The vision.
You found out you had this gift. What an extraordinary gift.
Now, no one likes a historian, Natasha. You know, this was for a Channel 10 publicity event that was required. No one needs to slow-mo that vision, nor see it ever. And this means war.
Okay, that's enough.
That's a bit of a stitch up that you did on Matt there. You actually cut some of yourself out of that.
Oh,
and we have it.
Tell me, Sarah, please.
We have it.
Okay. There we go.
Oh, dear. Oh, this is awful. This was close to a baby.
That is my favourite, actually. That is my favourite.
Wow. Isn't it great when the wheel comes full circle?
Yeah. I think the first case on your new crime show is going to be murder on the dance floor.
Touché. Very, very good. Thank you so much for that, guys. I think that is an example of why this place, 10, is such an amazing place to work. The people you can see there that have very kindly said some nice words about me after I paid them. Seriously, I'm going to miss you guys. I'm going to miss you very, very deeply. And it's been a beautiful place to work for 8 years. And thank you so much for
Don't cry yet, there's more to come. We're just going to take a very quick break. The fun continues in a moment. Don't go anywhere. Now, because it is Matt Doran's very last day at Network 10 before he moves to Hollywood to be a big TV star over there, we wanted to give you a bit of a going away present.
Ooh.
Can't let you say goodbye without cake.
Aww.
Aww. Beautiful Daniella. Beautiful Daniella is here from Buttercream Lane. How's that?
Wow.
Star Spangled Cake. Danielle, we love you.
And you make the most beautiful cakes.
How divine is that?
Oh. It's incredible. Would you like me to hold it up for the camera?
No. Last experience, I'm not sure about that very much.
Is there anything you'd like to say, Maddie?
I would just like to basically thank you guys and thank the network for an amazing 8 years in my career. I think 10 really brought me on to, taught me everything about journalism and the reason I love journalism, and I've made some friends for life here. There's absolutely no doubt about that. So it's a sad day for me as well as an exciting one. So thank you to the network. Thank you to you guys for all the kind words and the not so kind words today, Natasha Belling.
She's cheeky, isn't she?
Oh my God! I haven't. If you've got an hour and a half, I'll tell you after the show.
Do you think it's because she's getting on in years?
Well, would you know then as well? I don't know that Natasha would be all that happy about me divulging this today, Jess. Oh. But is it a certain birthday?
21.
21. Well,
again,
audience, do you think she's 21 or older? Yeah. No. 30 or older?
What?
I thought we were.
I like that when you ask the audience if they thought Tasha's 21, they all go, yes. Because they're scared that she's going to do a hatchet job on them too.
I know, exactly.
It's a big birthday today for you, Tash. You are 31.
Yay! Happy birthday, Tash.
Wow, what about your wide shot there with that one?
I won't eat all that at once. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Mwah. Happy birthday!
Oh,
thank you.
Don't look a day over.
Yes,
29.
Happy birthday, beautiful. And because we love our audience so much as well, like the love in continues. It's you're all love. Going home with a bag of treats.
I thought they were going to say they were going home with Jono Coleman, but that's.
So people can actually leave today and say, I've sucked Matt Doran's face.
Oh, wow.
And, being completely fine with it.
We'll see how many of them are left in the bin on the way out.
Oh, rubbish.
Fantastic. I can't believe you can go up to people and say, eat me.
That is brilliant. Oh, here we go. You've salvaged it.
We've got it out of the bin.
Just so you're not going home empty-handed. You're a big winner, Matt.
Thank you very much. Huge thank you to Daniella from Buttercream Lane for these amazing cakes. We love them. That is it for us for today. Angela Couturns, thank you very much
for
coming in.
Thank you for having me.
Matt, superstar.